will be speaking now with Dr. Winchell Sevilla. He is the Supervising Science Research Specialist of FEVOX. Dr. Sevilla, good afternoon to you. Thank you for joining us today and welcome to the program.
Yes, good afternoon, Ms. Carmina, and good afternoon to our listeners.
All right, where was FEVOX in terms of guidance, in terms of warning the residents before the eruption happened? Were there any signs prior to the eruption that happened last night? What does the data show when you monitor the activity of Mount Canlaon? Dr. Sevilla.
Yes, well, in fact, last May 26, 2024, we issued an advisory because we noticed that there's an increase in the volcanic activity in Canlaon. So we released an advisory telling them that there's a possibility of a phreatic eruption that might happen in Canlaon. So ito nga po, nagkaroon po ng eruption last night at around 6:15 p.m.
All right. Nung pag sinabi niyo pong May 26, you released an advisory, ito po ba ay sinulat niyo mismo, pinadala sa Canlaon City? Sino pong nakatanggap? If you can give us details.
Yes, ma'am. So we released the information, the usual channel post to the Office of the Civil Defense, yung partners po natin, mga local government units sa Negros Island, as well as nakapost po ito sa ating mga information channels like our website, aping pong Facebook page and Twitter po.
At sigurado po kayo na may nakatanggap dito? Kasi impending eruption ito eh. So hindi lang to basta warning, pero talagang sinigurado nyo ba na natanggap ang impormasyon at talagang handa sila in case may mangyari ng ganito?
Yes, ma'am. Before we release po an advisory, ini-inform po muna namin ang mga LGUs, ang ating po mga partner agencies para hindi po sila mabigla, nabigla na lang nag-release kami ng information. So prior to that, we gave them information, hey, we're seeing this abnormal activity or elevated seismic activity in Canlaon. And because of that, we're going to release an advisory. So yun nga po yung nangyari.
Mm-hmm. Why is it then that the head of the Public Information Office just told us a couple of minutes ago that they haven't received any guidance from FEVOX, that they were caught by surprise that with the eruption that happened last night? Dr. Sevilla.
Phreatic eruption po kasi yung nangyari kagabi. So usually po ang phreatic eruption is nag-o-occur siya ng walang clear na signals. So ang mga binibigay lang po natin mga informations ay, hey, look, mataas yung earthquake activities, mataas yung inire-release na gas, for example. So may chance na magkaroon ng phreatic eruption. Of course, we don't know when or kung kailan o anong oras. So ang payo po natin lagi or recommendations is always be vigilant. And kung sakali man po magkaroon ng ganun nga po, phreatic eruption, nakalagay naman po sa ating recommendations, is unang-una, let's protect ourselves na hindi po natin malanghap yung kung sakali man po magkakaroon ng ash fog, yung ash, kasi nga po delikado ito sa ating kalusugan.
No, Dr. Sevilla, I'm trying to trace the timeline here because as I spoke with Dr. Empiales, he gave us the impression that they were left to their own devices, that they would only check on the websites and not really on your website rather, and didn't really have that much of a guidance of any advisory coming from FEVOX itself. Ang sabi din po niya, dati-dati daw po ay merong tauhan ang FEVOX na nandun po mismo. Pero 3 years ago, pre-pandemic, ay nag-retire na daw po itong taong ito. At since then po, wala na pong regular na taga-FEVOX po ang nagbibigay po sa kanila ng abiso, ng guidance. Meron ba kayong tao doon sa Canlaon City po?
Yes, ma'am. Continuous naman po yung operations natin. Meron po tayong station sa La Carlota and sa Canlaon City and 24/7 nakaman po. Mm-hmm. And I think it's better to, ma-clear muna kayo, sir, bago po ako magbigay na information para po malaman natin kung saan yun. Issue.
Ano po yun?
Pero what I'm saying is may tao po dun sa Canlaon, sa observatories po natin sa Canlaon. Aman po siya 24/7.
Opo. At when did you last get in touch with your person there at the station?
Every day po, ma'am.
Every day po? Oo. So pagkatapos po nung...
ma'am, we are in constant communication po sa
observatory. At nakakasigurado po kayo na hindi lamang po kayong nag-uusap, kundi yung impormasyon na nakikita din po at yung datos na nakikita ng tao niyo po sa Mount Canlaon Station ay naidadownload din po niya dun sa LGU na maapektuhan?
Yes, ma'am.
And you're sure of that?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so Dr. Empiales is lying when he told us that he hasn't gotten, he hasn't gotten any.
I cannot comment on that, ma'am. I think it's better for, mag-usap po na, ma'am. Tingnan natin kung ano yung issue.
Okay, because complete...
Hindi po kami nagkakausap.
Ano po yun?
Maganda ma'am mag-usap muna kung ano po yung tunay na nangyari. Kasi ma'am, mahirap mag-comment kasi hindi ko rin nakadinig yung site.
Correct. Opo. Ito po yung clear na galing po sa kanila. Simula po nung nag-erupt, 6:51 p.m., ito po ay oras galing sa FIVOX. Ang sabi po ni Dr. Empiales, mismong siya po, given that he's the head of the Public Information Office, mula 6:51 hanggat nung nag-usap po kami a couple of minutes ago, wala daw pong pakikipag-ugnayan ang FIVOX sa kanilang tanggapan. And this is what they need. They need guidance, Dr. Sevilla. They need to know what is the current situation. Ano po ang datos na natatanggap ninyo? They need to know what advice they should give the residents if the residents should return to their homes. At the current situation po, at the current situation, should the residents be allowed to return to their homes? Kasi ang sabi po niya, wala na po masyadong sulfur na naaamoy. Visually, he says mukhang okay. Pero sa datos niyo po at nakukuha niyo pong impormasyon, is it, would you advise for residents to return to their homes?
Usually, ma'am, with regards to about sa recommendations to whether you know move yung mga nag-evacuate po babalik na sa lugar, it's a call of local government units po yan.
But it has to be science-based, Dr. Sevilla. They're lacking that. They don't know. I mean, they don't know what's happening underground, and that's why they're relying on you because you have the science.
Yes, ma'am. In fact, magkakaroon in constant communication sa po tayo sa ating mga stakeholders. And in fact, para po masagot lahat ng mga tanong, magkakaroon po mamaya ng press con at around 3 p.m. And nakakommunicate naman po ito. Ang pagkakaalam ko, latest news is nakakommunicate na po ito sa ating mga stakeholders, especially sa Negros Island.
Mm. Pero would you advise? Ano po yung information na nakukuha niyo po ngayon? Is there going to be another phreatic eruption? Do you detect any abnormal activities from where you sit, which would tell you that it's clear, it's clear for them to go home, or should they still remain in evacuation centers? Yan po ang inaasahan nila sa inyo.
So ngayon, ma'am, with regards to the signs, since 12 a.m. kagabi, and pinaka-latest po ngayon 12 noon, we recorded 43 volcanic earthquakes. And currently, cloud-covered po ang Canlaon. Pero yung during times po na nag-clear siya, there's still a voluminous white steam na lumalabas sa kanyang crater. Umabot siya ng mga 2 kilometers yung taas. Ang drip po ay south-southwest. Now, meron po kaming tinitingnan tatlong scenarios, if you will, na posibleng mangyari sa status ng Canlaon. Number one, based kung pagbabasihan po natin, we're going to base the historical activity ng eruptive activity po ng Canlaon. There's a possibility na magkaroon pa po ng mga phreatic eruptions sa mga darating na araw, although we don't know when or kung anong oras siya. But what's really important is if magkakaroon man po ng phreatic eruptions at itong phreatic eruptions nito ay mag-generate o magpo-produce ng ash or ashfall, ang key po dito ay maprotektahan ng ating mga kababayan, especially those living near Canlaon na maiwasan ma-inhale yung ash. So yan po yung ano, critical dyan. Second scenario is that may possibility na kung sakali mang mag-escalate yung activity, so at alert level 2, pwede po nating itaas to alert level 3. In the sense na significantly or dramatic, dadami yung volcanic earthquakes nating marerecord or yung mas tataas pa yung volcanic gas. But for now, yung level ng volcanic earthquakes na narerecord natin ay kasing taas ng mga volcanic earthquakes na na-record natin prior sa eruption kagabi. So yan po yung scenario number 2. Just in case lang na mag-escalate yung activity, then we're going to raise it to alert level 3. Third scenario, possible din po na after this activity, yung eruption kagabi, yung mga minomonitor nating parameters, for example, volcanic number of volcanic earthquakes, and yung amount ng sulfur dioxide na inire-release ng volcano ay bababa na yung level. So, kung yan po yung maobserbahan natin in the coming days, then we're going to lower the alert level to alert level 1. So, ang mahalaga po dito, we are, you know, kahit man po ever since, we're, you know, monitoring the volcano 24/7, and any information po, significant information na kailangan pong malaman natin ng ating mga stakeholders, ng ating mga kababayan, agad naman po natin ipinararating to sa kanila through various means of information.
Okay, we're going to track down how exactly the information is passed on to the stakeholders and to those who have been affected by the phreatic explosion of Mount Canlaon. Aside from those three scenarios, what should they be on the lookout for in the next 24 hours, Dr. Sevilla?
For now, what's really critical po ay, yun nga po, possibility of another phreatic eruption na pwede pong magdulot ng ashfall. And what's the key here, key po doon ay we have to protect ourselves na malangha po yung kung sakali man po magkaroon ng ashfall dun sa communities nyo, we have to protect ourselves not to ma-inhale po ito.
When was the last time that Canlaon erupted? And was it a violent one?
Usually po, ang style po ng eruptions ng Canlaon ay phreatic. Since 1866, lahat po ng kanyang style ng eruptions ay phreatic. So meron na po tayong, so far na ito lang, 43 na instances or episodes ng eruptions.
Okay.
Except po 1902 na meron pong na-report na may lumabas pong lava. Pero other than that, yung the rest po mga phreatic type.
Yung so, mga bato, yung may mga malalaking bato, is that something that they should be on the lookout for as well?
Based po sa survey na ginawa po ng aming colleagues last night yung during the eruption, so nag-ikot na po sila para po mag-survey kung saan dinala yung abo, yung extent niya. Meron pong, usually po mga abo, mga fine grain, pero minsan po may mga pebble size. So, pero po itong mga pebble size na ito, mga na documents po ito din po sa, malapit lang po sana, sa Bulgaria.
So may tao kayo, you have colleagues there as we speak. Monitoring,
yes,
the situation. Maybe after we talk, maybe it's a good idea to, you know, make a phone call and tell them to head on over to the PIO, because we're talking about lives getting affected here.
It's better not to talk and, you know, clear the issues first before, you know, we make a statement. And but like I said, ma'am, 24/7 monitored po ang Canlaon volcano. And in fact, yung mga tauhan po natin sa main office, they go there at may scheduled and po sila field works doon to do campaign surveys like ground deformation surveys. They also scheduled, minomonitor po nila yung level po ng nilalabas na sulfur dioxide ng Canlaon volcano.
All right. And there's also one other curious thing that happened last week, and this is what Dr. Empiales told us a while ago. There's a cold spring there in Canlaon City, and all of a sudden last week, it spewed a sand-like substance, and sulfur was smelled, was evident in the air. Could this have been a sign that an impending phreatic eruption would happen, was going to happen?
Marami po kasing phreatic eruption nag-occur po siya anytime. Kasi po dalawa lang naman yung ingredients niyo to generate a phreatic eruption. One is heat source, the other one is water. Kung present po yung dalawa na yun, so malaki po chance ang magkaroon ng phreatic eruptions. Now, based po dun sa observation ni Sir, we can bring people in there to further investigate. But like I said, wala naman pong definite na pagka nakita mo ito, magpa-phreatic na.
All right, but does that point to increased activity? Hindi rin po.
Hindi naman po.
Okay.
Kasi po, active po yung tinatawag nating hydrothermal system ng Canlaon volcano.
Uh-huh.
So, but definitely po, like I said, since mataas na po, 2020, in-raise na po namin yung alert level sa Canlaon to level 1 because we're seeing these abnormal activities.
Mm-hmm.
And yun nga po, most recent, recently, May 26, we released an advisory. Hey, look, we have elevated levels of seismicity. The amount, the volume of sulfur dioxide was quite high. So please, sabi po namin, recommendations, be vigilant, pwede pong magkaroon ng phreatic eruptions, and you know, avoid the 4 kilometer permanent danger zone.
All right, we're going to have to leave it at that. Our hope really is for, you know, any miscommunication that may have occurred, for that to be resolved at the soonest possible time, because as I said, we go back to lives being affected here, and they're looking at you for guidance as well. They're looking to your office as well for guidance as well. Dr. Sevilla there, Winchell Sevilla of FEVOX, thank you so much for joining us today. Really appreciate your insights. Maraming salamat po.
Salamat po.